Hey data science professionals, it's Emma from emmadin.com. In this video, I want to talk about the challenge of learning data science interviews and what to do about it. So far this year, I have talked with over 70 data scientists who are actively looking for jobs. And most of them have expressed concern with me about the current job market. The market is very competitive right now. It seems that there are many more job seekers than job opportunities, and the supply is much larger than the demand. The difficulty of landing interviews applies to not only people who are looking for their first data science job, but also experienced data scientists who have over 5 years of experience. As we all know, landing interviews is the first step to land the offer you want. Without interviews, it's nearly impossible to move forward in the hiring process. Not landing interviews might be the reason you feel frustrated or discouraged with your job search process so far. In this video, I'm going to show you a few methods you can use immediately to land interviews effectively. Now, before we dive into today's topic, I want to show you this PDF I have collected. I have done some research and gathered a list of US companies hiring data scientists. I went to their website and see if there's any data scientist job openings. And also, I've done some research. I have put the contact information of the hiring managers and recruiters from those companies in this PDF. My goal is to save you time, and hopefully with this information, you can speed up your job search process a little bit. If you think this PDF is going to be helpful for you, you can use the link in the video description to download it. Okay, now let's back to our topic. Before we dive into those methods, I want to spend some time to talk about the challenges you guys might be facing with. The first challenge is that you are spending lots of time perfecting your resume and sending out applications only to not get any interviews. The competition is fierce, and your resume never got picked up by recruiters or hiring managers. The second challenge that some of you might be facing with is that you have landed some interviews, but those interviews are not from companies you want to work with. If that's the case, even if you work super hard to prepare for interviews and eventually you land an offer, you won't be excited because those companies are not your first choice. The third challenge, or something that may frustrate you, is that you feel it's completely out of your control. You feel it's up to the hiring managers and the recruiters to determine if you're a good fit for the role or not, and to determine if they want to give you interviews. It seems that there's nothing you can do to change the situation. Now, if you're facing with any of these challenges, today's video will be helpful for you because I'm gonna share with you a few methods you can do and one thing you can stop doing to land interviews effectively. Now, we talked about the challenges you guys might be facing with. Let's talk about the ideal scenario. What is the ideal scenario for landing interviews? First of all, you want to increase your success rate from applications to interviews, right? Let's say if right now your success rate is 10%, you send out 100 applications and you get 10 interviews, we want to increase that rate to 50% or even more. Secondly, you want to land interviews from companies you really want to work with. It will be great if you can land interviews easily and quickly, especially from the companies you're really passionate about. Well, the best scenario is that hiring managers and recruiters reach out to you for interview opportunities instead of you have to reach out to them to get interviews. With this goals in mind, let's talk about a few methods you can use and one thing you should stop doing to land interviews effectively. Let's start with one thing that you can stop doing, and that is submitting applications. In today's job market, simply submitting applications does not work anymore. I have talked with a few friends who are data science managers at different tech companies, and they shared this data with me. On average, there are over 400 applicants for a single data scientist job opening. I also asked ChatGPT to give me a more precise number. So here's what it tells me. It says, according to a survey by job search website Indeed, data science job postings in the US received an average of 94.5 applications per job in 2020. This number can be higher or lower depending on the specific job and location. This data is in 2020, and I don't have the latest number for 2023, but as you can tell, you will be competing against hundreds of applicants for a single data scientist job opening. So that is probably why you haven't landed as many interviews as you want, especially if your dream companies are top-tier tech companies. It's very possible that the opportunity is gone even before the hiring manager or the recruiter look at your resume. Well, what surprised me was that after talking with 70 data scientists in the last few weeks, over 50 of them only rely on submitting applications to land interviews. If that's you, that's okay, but I want to let you know that this method is not effective to land interviews, and there are a few ways you can do to increase your chance of landing interviews. First of all, it's time to reach out to the gatekeepers. When I say gatekeepers, I mean recruiters and hiring managers. Impress them using the right method and show them that you're not just a random applicant, but someone who is genuinely interested in the company and who can contribute to the team and the company. So how do you impress them using the right method? Instead of just asking for an interview, you provide the value first. One of my students, Shah, went above and beyond. He has done lots of research for each company he wants to interview with, and he created a recent report and shared it with different hiring managers. Despite being a new grad and not having much industry experience, he was able to land interviews with Apple, Uber, Discord, etc. With his permission, I'm gonna share his method with you guys.
This was a role that I reached out to hiring manager and he put me in the interview, He set up the interview call. And then I created this document for him. It was a Apple TV Plus role.
Yeah.
So I did.
Wow, that's great. Yes. Wow, lots of research.
Yeah, so I did some research. I tried to understand what is the state of streaming industry and then how does sports streaming work and why did Apple get into that. So I tried to... I did some research on internet and put it together, and then I defined metrics. I'm not sure if these are the right metrics or not, but yeah,
this is great. I mean, this definitely will impress the hiring manager.
Isn't that amazing? Think about it. If you're the hiring manager, are you going to be convinced by this person's ability to bring value to the company? Yes, you will, because this person has done this research even before they joined the company, right? Now, I know you might be thinking, this seems like a good strategy, but it seems like a lot of work. Well, you only have a limited number of companies that you are interested in working with, right? You don't want to work with any companies in the world. So pick the companies you are interested in and create this kind of research report to share with them. This is going to be effective because no one is doing this. Everyone is expecting to land interviews by clicking a button and simply submitting their resume, and that is not working anymore. Another method I want to share with you is to leverage referrals. Having someone who can refer you to their companies can be the most effective way to land interviews. If you know someone who works at the company you want to work with, don't hesitate to ask for a referral, given that they know you and they know you're going to be a strong candidate. Having someone who can vouch for you can be the most effective method to land interviews. On top of that, there are other benefits for you to build a strong professional network and have someone who can refer you. One benefit is that there might be some opportunities that are not public on the company's website, and if you have network within the company, then you can know those opportunities before they are going public. So you will be the first one to know the opportunity and probably also the first one to be considered for such opportunities. It's important to build strong professional network in today's job market. It may seem time-consuming to build relationships with professionals, but this method has long-term benefits. The last method I want to share with you is to leverage LinkedIn to build strong personal brand on the platform. This is a method that is often overlooked. Nowadays, many hiring managers and recruiters use LinkedIn to select candidates. They look at your work experience, your skill sets, And if you have any recommendation from your managers and peers to evaluate your qualification, they prefer to use LinkedIn than resumes because it's easy to use. If they feel you are qualified for a position, they can message you directly and they can also see who you are connected with. However, many people's LinkedIn profile is close to blank, so there are some missing opportunities there. You know, among all the data scientists I have talked with in the last 2 months, about 10% of them have no problems getting interviews. They got lots of interview invitations from recruiters and hiring managers on LinkedIn. That's all because of the strong personal brand they built on the platform. So if you can spend some time and put in a little effort to improve your LinkedIn profile, you can stand out and even catch the attention of recruiters and hiring managers. They may even reach out to you instead of you have to reach out to them for interview opportunities. So we talk about a few methods to land interviews. Let's compare those methods in terms of time you need to spend and effectiveness to land interviews. So let's draw this diagram with the x-axis being time and the y-axis being the effectiveness to land interviews. And the role applications is about here. It's the easiest, but it's the least effective to land interviews. And we also talk about reaching out to gatekeepers. It's about here. So you can reach out to hiring managers and recruiters directly and impress them using the right method. You can share them with the research you have done to let them know that you're not a random applicant, but someone who is genuinely interested in working with them. Okay, so gatekeepers is much more effective than role applications, but it may also take you some time to do the research and to reach out to hiring managers and recruiters. We also talk about leveraging referrals. It can be a very effective method, but you need to spend some time to build the relationships with professionals. Another method we mentioned is building your LinkedIn profile, right? Build a strong personal brand on the platform. So this method can also be very effective. If you have a strong personal brand on the platform, chances are recruiters and hiring managers reach out to you instead of you reach out to them. So if we compare the time and effectiveness of these methods, that's how I see the four methods to land interviews. Now, action items for you guys. If you have been using role applications to land interviews and you can stop doing it and you can start with building a personal brand on LinkedIn, and eventually you want to leverage all three methods to help you land interviews. All right, guys, that's all the methods I want to share with you to land interviews in today's competitive job market. Again, if you want this PDF that I have collected, over 40 US companies hiring data scientists, you can use the link in the video description and download the PDF. I hope this can be helpful for you. Remember that you cannot fail if you don't give up. So keep trying, and I wish you all the best with your job search process. I will see you soon.